Now we'll discuss some more questions. The question is, prove that cos pi by 4 plus x plus cos pi by 4 minus x is equal to root 2 cos x. So in proving, we have to prove finally left hand side equals to right hand side. So I'm going to start with left hand side part. So left side is here, cos pi by 4 plus x plus cos pi by 4 minus x. So here, one identity we can use apply. That identity is, according to question we have to apply. We have to read the question carefully, and after that we have to apply the identity. Here identity we can use, that is 2 cos x into cos y equals to cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y. So this part, x plus cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y, we can use this left hand side like that. So cos of x plus y, here x equals to pi by 4, y is x, plus cos of x minus y, pi by 4 minus x. So directly we can apply the identity. So it will be 2 cos x is here pi by 4 into cos of x. So cos of pi by 4, we know that the value is 1 by root 2. So finally, value we are getting here, root 2 into root 2 as 2, we can write, and this is root 2 cos x. So this is the answer. Now next question, based on the identity, that is, find value of cos 5x plus cos 3x. So we have discussed one identity, that was cos x plus cos y. So here we will use that. So we know that identity, 2 cos x plus y by 2 into cos x minus y by 2. So directly I'm going to apply it. Cos 5x plus cos 3x equals to 2 cos 5x plus 3x by 2 into cos 5x minus 3x by 2. So we can write it as 2 cos 8x by 2 into cos of 2x by 2. So finally, we can write it as 2 cos 4x into cos x. So this is our answer. One more question I am taking here, that is, find value of sine 5x minus sine x. So here we'll apply identity, sine x minus sine y. So we know that it is 2 cos x into, 2 cos x plus y by 2 into sine x minus y by 2. So I'm going to apply here, 2 cos x is here 5x plus y is here x by 2 into sine 5x minus x by 2. So 2 cos x cos 6x by 2 into sine 4x by 2. So finally we'll have here 2 cos 3x cos 3x into sine 2x. So this is our answer. Two more identities we will discuss. Actually, these identities are not there in the NCERT book, but I am discussing now. So for all x, y belongs to real numbers R, so the first identity is sine of x plus y into sine of x minus y. It is equals to sine square x minus sine square y. And second identity is cos of x plus y into cos of x minus y. Then it is equals to cos square x minus sine square y. So I'm going to derive these two one by one. So sine of x plus y into sine of x minus y, first one, equals to sine square x minus sine square y. So I'm going to start with left hand side part. So left hand side of this, sine of x plus y into sine of x minus y, and this is sine x cos y. Sine x plus y, we know that sine x cos y plus cos x sine y into sine x minus y, sine x cos y minus cos x sine y. Now I'm going to multiply. So after multiplying, I'm getting here, this is a plus b into a minus b. So a square minus b square. So sine square x into cos square y minus cos square x into sine square y. So I'm writing it as sine square x cos square y as 1 minus sine square y, because right side is there in sine only. Because of that, I'm converting cos into sine, minus 1 minus sine square x. Cos square x equals to 1 minus sine square x into sine square y. So sine square x minus sine square x into sine square y minus sine square y plus sine square x into sine square y. So we can write it as sine square x minus sine square y. Right hand side part proved. Similarly, we'll prove the second one. Cos of x plus y into cos of x minus y equals to cos square x minus sine square y. So I'm going to start with left side. So cos x plus y into cos x minus y. So one by one I'm applying here, cos x plus y. This is cos x cos y minus sine x sine y into cos x minus y. This is minus 2 sine, cos x minus y, that is cos x cos y plus sine x sine y. Now again here we will apply a minus b into a plus b, so a square minus b square. So cos square x into cos square y minus sine square x into sine square y. So we can write it as cos square x 1 minus sine square y minus means cos square y I have converted into 1 minus sine square y. Minus sine square x I am converting into 1 minus cos square x. By using the identity, we know that identity we are using here, cos square x plus sine square x equals to 1. Now multiplying it, cos square x minus cos square x into sine square y minus sine square y plus sine square y into cos square x. So finally here these two terms we can reduce and we have cos square x minus sine square y. These are the two identities also you have to remember. Now by use of this identity, means question based on this identity, so the question is, prove that sine square 6x minus sine square 4x equals to sine 10x into sine 2x. This is the question. So I'm going to start with left hand side. sine square 6x minus sine square 4x. So we know the identity, that was sine square x minus sine square y is equals to sine of x plus y into sine of x minus y. So I'm going to apply it. So this is sine of 6x plus 4x into sine of 6x minus 4x. So it is sine of 10x into sine of 2x. So right hand side we are getting root. Now we'll find out values of these trigonometric functions. First is sine 18 degree, then cos 18 degree, then cos 36 degree and sine 36 degree. So first I'm going to start with sine 18 degree. So sine 18 degree. We'll consider here theta angle equals to 18 degree. Now multiplying both sides by 5. So it will be a 5 theta, 5 into 18 degree. So we have 5 theta equals to 90 degree. Now we can split 5 theta as 2 theta plus 3 theta. Now equals to 90 degree. Now we can write it as 2 theta equals to 90 degree minus 3 theta. And then we have to find out sine of 18. So taking both sides function sine. Sine 2 theta equals to sine of 90 minus 3 theta. So we can write sine of 90 minus 3 theta as cos 3 theta. We know that. And sine 2 theta, we are knowing by the identity 2 sine theta into cos theta. So this is equals to cos 3 theta. Here we are using sine 2 theta. That is 2 sine theta into cos theta. Now again we will apply one more identity, that is cos 3 theta. Cos 3 theta we are knowing, that is 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. So I'm applying here 2 sine theta into cos theta equals to 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. Now I'm taking all the values in left hand side. So it will be 2 sine theta into cos theta minus 4 cos cube theta plus 3 cos theta equals to 0. Now from each term we can take common cos, because cos is there in each term. So I'm going to take common cos theta from each term. So after taking common, I'm getting here 2 sine theta minus 4 cos square theta plus 3 equals to 0. Here, cos theta equals to 0, or 2 sine theta minus 4 cos square theta plus 3 equals to 0. We can't take cos theta equals to 0 because cos theta means cos of 18 degree according to this question, and this should not be equals to 0 here, because we know that cos 0 is 0. So we can take here 2 sine theta minus 4 cos square theta plus 3 equals to 0. Now here we can apply cos square theta as 1 minus sine square theta. So 2 sine theta minus 4 1 minus sine square theta plus 3 equals to 0. Now we'll calculate it. 2 sine theta minus 4 plus 4 sine square theta plus 3 equals to 0. So here we have 4 sine square theta plus 2 sine theta minus 1 equals to 0. Now you can see this is in the form of quadratic equation. So we can find out here roots. So sine theta equals to minus 2 minus a, x equals to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. So this form we are using. So minus 2 plus minus root over 4 plus 16 by 8. So finally we'll have here minus 1 plus minus root 20 by 8, minus 2 plus minus root 20 by 8. So 2 we can take common from here. So it is minus 1 plus minus root 5 by 8. So it is minus 1 plus minus root 5 by 4. But we have taken theta positive. So here we will take only positive value. Means minus 1 minus root 5 by 4 we will not take. We will take here minus 1 plus root 5 by 4. So I am going to write here sine theta equals to minus 1 plus root 5 by 4. So this is the value of sine 18 degree. Minus 1 plus root 5 by 4. Now we'll find out value of cos 18 degree. So we know that sine 18 degree value. We will use that cos sine 18 degree value. Just now we have seen that is root 5 minus 1 by 4. So I'm going to use it. We know that one identity, that is cos square x plus sine square x equals to 1. So here cos square 18 plus sine square 18 equals to 1. So cos square 18 degree equals to 1 minus sine square 18 degree. So cos of 18 degree equals to root over 1 minus sine square 18 degree. Now sine 18 degree value I'm going to apply. So root over 1 minus root 5 minus 1 by 16. 1 by 4 whole square. And this is root over 1 minus root 5 minus 1 whole square by 16. So calculating it. So here 1 by root 16, I can write it as 1 by 4. Then root over 16 minus root 5 minus 1 whole square. So this is 16 minus 5 minus 2 root 5 plus 1, 1 by 4 root over, it will be 10 minus 2 root 5. So finally, the value will be root over 10 minus 2 root 5 by 4. And this is cos 18 degree value. Now we'll find out cos 36 degree value. Third one, cos 36. So here we have to use identity. That identity is cos 2x, 1 minus 2 sine square x. So here we are considering cos 36, we can write as cos of 2 into 18, because 18 degree value we are knowing. Because of that, I'm splitting like that. Now cos 2 into 18. So I'm applying here this identity cos 2x. So it is 1 minus 2 sine square 18 degree. So 1 minus 2 sine 18 degree whole square. So 1 minus 2 sine 18 degree value, we know that is root 5 minus 1 by 4. So root 5 minus 1 by 4 whole square. So 1 minus 2, just we have to calculate by 16. This is root 5 minus 1 whole square. So 1 minus, we can write it as 1 by 8. 1 by 8. And this has 5 minus 2 root 5 plus 1. So 8 minus 5 plus 2 root 5 minus 1 by 8. 2 plus 2 root 5 by 8. So it is 1 plus root 5 by 4. So this is our answer. Cos 36 degree, we are getting 1 plus root 5 by 4. Then we can find out sine 36 degree by using cos 36 degree value. So sine 36 degree, we can write, we know that identity sine square x plus cos square x equals to 1. So I'm going to use that identity. So according to that, sine 36 degree equals to root over 1 minus cos square 36 degree. So root over 1 minus cos 36 degree value I'm going to apply. That is root 5 plus 1 by 4. So it is root 5 plus 1 by 4 whole square. So just we have to calculate 1 minus 5 plus 2 root 5 plus 1 by 16. So it is, we write as 16 minus 5 minus 2 root 5 minus 1 by 16. So we have here root over 10 minus 2 root 5 by 4. So this is cos 36 degree. So like that we can find out sine 72 degree, cos 72 degree, then sine 54 degree, cos 54 degree.